you by the airwaves. We welcome you to join us as we enter to the throne of grace. If you have a need today, just lift it up to Jesus. Jesus knows your heart. He said, ask and you shall receive. If you want something from the Lord today, he said, seek and you'll find it. So let's pray. Believe in God for just what he said. Heavenly Father, Lord, we're so thankful today, God, for all of your blessings. Lord, for the way that you move in our life, for the way, God, that you carried us through the valley. You help us up the mountain. And Lord, God, you help us when we reach the mountaintop. Lord, I'm thankful today that you're the same yesterday, today, and forever. And in this hour, God, again, we ask that you would come in. And Lord, God, you would minister amongst us. Lord, we're going to worship you with everything we've got. Lord, we're going to give it all to you, Jesus. For you gave your all for us. Lord, we're looking forward, God, to your word today. We're looking forward to every song. God, I pray for those that are by the internet, Lord, that you would touch in their need. God, you would bless in their lives. Father, that through these internet ways, the power of the Holy Ghost would flow into somebody. Lord, somebody's way in their path. Put a stop sign there, Lord. And God, if they're headed the wrong direction, issue them a U-turn. Father, in the name of Jesus, we pray. Amen. And amen. Hallelujah. Lord, thank you, Lord. Brought your singing voice. At least a voice. Did you bring a voice? Amen. You see, the Bible says, make a joyful noise unto the Lord. Somebody told me one time, well, Pastor Kenny, if I make a noise that isn't joyful, I just want to share with you. If you're blessing the Lord, it's joyful. It's sort of like when your kids come to you and say, Mommy or Daddy, thank you, I love you. You remember that feeling you have? May I remind you, brother and sister, you are made in the image of Christ. And if you feel that way, that's because God feels that way. And I don't know anybody else in this world that deserves the thanks like he does. Amen? Yeah. So hey, turn around your neighbor and say, you can sing.
Yeah. You can sing.
You can sing.
Amen.
Amen. Hallelujah. Bless the Lord. Grab your red hymnal and turn to page 164. 164 in your red hymnal. Hallelujah. Amen. Have you got it? Say praise the Lord.
If the world were wet full of its silver and its gold, and you had to get along with the earth there, just remember there.
Thank you.
I settled it long ago.
Amen.
Hallelujah. I hope y'all enjoying it. I shouldn't have turned the heat on. Some of y'all really enjoying it. I'm melting. Amen. How many of y'all think it feels good in here? Go see the doctor. Y'all sick. Amen. Hallelujah. It's just right, Brother Steve.
It's okay with me.
Maybe I'm the sick one even. How you like that? Turn to page 180 and let's sing Everybody Will Be Happy over there. Amen. Hallelujah. Bless the Lord. Everybody will be happy. I'm telling you, I'm happy right now. When I get there, I believe I'll be a little more happier. Amen. Y'all think I'm crazy now? Wait till I make it to heaven. Hallelujah. Bless the Lord. You're going to say, Jesus, where'd that pastor go? He's going to say, that's that crazy one making all that noise down the street of gold. Amen. I got a lot to praise him for. Amen.
Amen.
Well, there's a happy land of all over in that and beyond. There's a good one that shouts to the glory appreciate that. We need you to give him an offering today. Amen. I'm going to ask you just to look to God, reach down in your heart, and ask God what He'd have you to give. I'm going to ask Sister Debbie to pray over our offering. You pray and ask God as she prays and leads us. Yes. Amen, Sister Debbie.
Mm-hmm. Hallelujah. Mm-hmm. Father, we come to you today. We just pray for this offering. We pray for those that have and those that have not. Please, Lord, just make sure that we have what we need.
Hallelujah.
Bless this offering in Jesus' name. We pray.
Amen. Amen. All right, Sister Tammy. Hallelujah. Bless the Lord. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Oh, Lord. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. I hope this song will bless your heart. Will I am Amen. Thank you, Brother Tom. You did a great job. Give the Lord a hand clap of praise for Brother Tom today. Amen. Hallelujah. Bless the Lord. In your Bibles, turn to the book of John. The 15th chapter. John chapter 15. And I'm going to take my text today from verses 1 through verse 8. St. John chapter 15, verse 1 through verse 8. Hallelujah. Bless the Lord. If you've got it, would you shout praise the Lord?
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah. And we read in the Word of God this. I am the true vine, and my Father is the husbandman. Every branch in me that beareth not fruit, he takes away, and every branch that beareth fruit, he purges that it may bring forth more fruit. Now you are clean through the word which I have spoken unto you. Verse number 4. Abide in me and I in you, as the branch cannot bear fruit in itself except that it abides in the vine. No more can ye except you abide in me. I am the vine. You are the branch. He that abideth in me and I in him, the same will bring forth much fruit. For without me you can do nothing. Can somebody say amen?
Amen.
If a man abides not in me, he is cast forth as a branch that is withered, and men gather him up and cast them into the fire, and they are burned. But if you abide in me, and my word abides in you, you can ask what you will, and it shall be done unto you. Herein is my Father glorified, that you bear much fruit, and so shall you be my disciples. Amen?
Amen.
Heavenly Father, I ask for the anointing of the Holy Spirit. Lord, I'm thankful, God, for your word. I know that's anointed. Lord, it was anointed when it was given to men of old. But God, I'm praying for this man right now. Lord, that the anointing of God would rest heavy upon me. And Lord God, the anointing of God would not only rest upon me, but sweet Holy Spirit, we take and ask that you would touch every heart, Lord, in this place and by the airways to receive this word. God, I pray that your spirit would bear witness with our spirit this morning. Lord, that we would know this is a word from you. And Father, that we would not be hearers of this word only, but God, we would take this world into the highways and the hedges and compel them to come in. Father, our plea today is, let us draw clearer or nearer to you and closer, Lord. Lord, clear out all obstacles out of our way that would hinder us from receiving the truth of your word. God, for it's in Jesus' name I pray. And everybody says, amen.
Amen.
And amen. I want to get right down to it today. Is that all right? Today I want to tell you that Jesus is the vine. Jesus is the vine. You may think that you're the one that controls it all. But I want to tell you something. Jesus is the source of everything.
Amen.
You breathe today because Jesus.
Yes.
Your heart beats today because Jesus.
Yes.
Your mind is thinking right now because of Jesus.
That's right.
You're hearing today because of Jesus. Amen. You're breathing in oxygen because of Jesus. You're letting out carbon monoxide because of Jesus. You are living in your house because of Jesus. You are driving your car because of Jesus. See, Jesus is your sustenance.
Amen. That's right.
That's where we have to start at today.
Yes.
That's where we have to come to grips at today. Listen to what the Word of God says. Jesus said, I'm the vine. Now, how many of you know that many branches branch off of the vine? But there is not one branch within itself that has the power to bear fruit or to live except they draw sustenance in the vine. Did you hear what I said? You and I can't do one thing except that we go into the vine to find our help. If you're scared in the dark, run to the vine. If you're facing a situation you don't know where to go, run to the vine. I keep trying this, preacher, and it's not working. Run to the vine. I'm going through so much heartache, and I'm having such a hard time. Run to the vine. I don't know if I'm going to pass my test. Run to the vine. I don't know if I'm going to be bullied this week. Run to the vine. Jesus said, I'm the vine. And you are the branch. And you can't abide. You can't live. You can't breathe. You can't overcome things. You can't overcome habits. You can't do right. You can't be good except that you suck out of the vine. Somebody turn to your neighbor and say, we better get to the vine. Hallelujah. You see, the vine is your souls. I don't care how many hours you put in at your job. You're never going to make enough money to be satisfied until you abide in the vine. You can chase after your rainbow. But you're going to be disappointed when you get to the other end. But if you look to the sky, if you look to the heavens, and you roll back the curtain of what you can't see, and you look into the portals of glory to what you can see, you look in and you find Jesus, and you cry out, Jesus, I need you. Jesus, I've got to have you. Jesus, I can't do this without you. All of a sudden, strength starts to swell up into your body. You say, I don't think that's true. Well, let me tell you, it is true. Last Saturday, my leg started hurting. It was hurting really bad. Sunday, I got up and preached. I didn't feel the hurt. When I got out of the pulpit, got in my chair, decided to rest, the hurt came back. Monday came by. I went to the doctor. The doctor said, you have a blood clot in your leg. Tuesday, I went to the doctor. Can I share with you? Thursday, they took me and made me go to the hospital. Here it is Sunday, and I'm abiding in the vine. Somebody shall praise the Lord. I'm standing in the vine. Now, my doctor said, don't jump, don't run, don't do any of that stuff. But I'm pretty confident if I'm abiding in the vine and that blood clot decides to move, hallelujah, I'm going to see Jesus and the place where roses never fade, hallelujah. And if God decides to meet me with you, I'm going to shout, praise the Lord. I'm going to glorify His name because I'm abiding in the vine. Yes.
Amen.
My God, hallelujah. I'm abiding in the vine. Listen to what he goes on to say. Listen to this. Every branch in him. Listen to what I'm telling you. These are the folks that come to church every Sunday, every Wednesday, and act like the devil the rest of the days of the week. These are the folks that come to church, say they love God, and sit on the bountiful seat of do nothing. Why do you call it bountiful, Pastor? Because there's a whole lot of people on that bench. The Word of God says this, every branch in him that bears no fruit is cast away. You see, it's not just about saying a little prayer.
Right.
It's not about just confessing your sin.
Right.
Although if you confess your sin, he is faithful and just to forgive you and to cleanse you from all unrighteousness. But let me just share with you today. It's about having a relationship inside the vine.
That's
and stop
right.
trying to do things and stop being hard-headed and stop being disrespectful and stop being, oh my God,
yes,
in the house.
Yes.
Hallelujah. And start getting into Jesus and let the love of God flow out of you so people will be drawn to you like a bug to a light.
That's it. Amen.
Hallelujah.
Thank you.
And the Bible says when we lift him up, men will be drawn unto him.
Amen.
You see, there's more than just getting saved. Getting saved is wonderful.
Right.
But he saved you for a purpose. Rick Warren, God bless him, wrote The Purpose-Driven Life. I'm going to tell you what your purpose is. Your purpose is to do the will of the Father, to bring glory through the Son to the Father.
Right. Amen.
Because you understand, the Word said he was the vine, but God was the husbandman. The Word said he was the vine. I'm thankful for the vine. The vine is wonderful. I'm thankful for Jesus Christ. I'm praising God for salvation. I'm praising God for deliverance. I'm praising God for healing. I'm praising God to be here. But can I tell you, I'm loving being in the vine, but there's a husbandman who's looking at the vine. Mm-hmm. And he's checking out the branches.
Right.
Now, any of you that do any planting, you know you've got to discard the branches that are dead. Mm-hmm. Sometimes you don't even have to, Brother Tom. Sometimes they discard themselves. Mm. Pastor, what are you talking about? How many of you know somebody that's walked away from God in the church? Mm-hmm. Because they weren't abiding in the vine. They were abiding in the pastor to bring a good message. Mm-hmm. They were abiding in the music to stir their heart. Mm-hmm. They were abiding in the fellowship so they could get their belly full. But when it came to a relationship with God, they didn't have any. How do you know they didn't have any? Because I've been inspecting some fruit. And the husbandman, hello? And when that branch in that vine doesn't abide in that vine. You see, you don't just read your Bible. When I say open your Bible here, somewhere in your house you found a quiet spot. And you've come together maybe as a family or your private time with the Lord. And you've opened up His Word, and you've read what the Scripture says, and you put it to action in that day.
Amen.
Listen to this. There's a whole lot of vines out there. We today call them weeds. Turn to your neighbor and say, are you living in a weed?
Hallelujah. My Lord.
You'll have to forgive me. They put me on a new medication, drives my throat out, but we're all right, aren't we?
Amen.
Somebody say, praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
You see, some people want to abide in the weeds. How many of you ever seen that weed comes up green, it's got prickers in it?
Oh, yeah.
How many of you ever stepped on one of them?
Yeah.
Nobody's happy then, and that's not the anointing of the Holy Ghost making you dance. You've been stuck by the weed. You've been pricked by sin. Can we just say hallelujah?
Hallelujah.
And the Word says this. You need to abide in the true vine. Let me tell you a little something. My father-in-law and I went down somewhere off 66. I won't tell you where. We probably shouldn't have been there. How many of you like blackberry cobbler? Let me see hands. Any blackberry cobbler? Oh yeah, praise God. We went down to pick some blackberries. Brother Tom, do you know in that blackberry patch, the fruit was there, but it was something else there too. It was some thorns and some thistles. And I could deal with the thorns and the thistles. That wasn't what got me. Can I share with you, church? The thing that got me while picking the blackberries for my blackberry cobbler was not the prickers on the vine or the thorns on the vine. It wasn't the little bugs crawling around on the ground. It wasn't the fact that snakes like to scroll through the vines. It was a little black thing called a tick. Hello? Can I share with you, when you've been in the vine or you've been out of the vine, somebody's going to know it.
There's going to be something that clings hold of you that you're going to draw out from where you've been. You play with sin, you're going to smell like a sinner.
That's right.
You have a relationship in the vine, you're going to come out fresh smelling. People are going to hate your guts.
Yep.
Because you used to be the party person. Mm-hmm. You used to be the light. You used to be the easy. You used to be the fun person. But I'm going to tell you something. I'd trade a whole house full of fun for one glimpse of glory any day of the week. I'd trade, hallelujah, going out and getting drunk. I'd trade going out and doing drugs. I'd trade all those things for one opportunity to hear Jesus say, "Well done, good and faithful servant. I'm proud of you. You've done a great job. You've ministered in my name. And you've given the touch as I poured it through you."
Praise the Lord.
Church, I want to share something with you today. I want you to hear something. You're not going to dabble in sin. Hear what I'm telling you. And not have some fruit from it.
That's right.
Well, Pastor Kenny, this is just a little thing. I'm not doing nothing real bad. The Bible says it is the little foxes that spoil your vine.
Right.
It's the things that people look over that destroy people from within. Listen to what I'm telling you. Jesus said, "I'm the vine. I'm the vine. You can choose to abide out of me, but you're going to die. You can choose to do your own thing, but you're going to dry up, shrivel, and be good for nothing. And the husbandman is going to come and take you off, and they're going to cast you into fire where the weeping and the gnashing of teeth never stops, and the fire is never quenched." Pastor, I don't think that's a good thing to preach. That's the problem with America today. Too many wishy-washy pastors standing in pulpits accepting everything that comes around. We need somebody to hold up the blood-stained banner of Jesus Christ and say what's right and say what's wrong according to the Word of God.
That's right. Amen.
Listen to the Word of God. "Every branch in him that bears no fruit, you're cast away." I didn't write this. If you'll note in your Bible, these letters are in red. This represents what Jesus said. Yes. Are you with me? Jesus is preaching and teaching a sermon here. "Pastor Kenny, that's awful mean. I want to do what I want." You can. Do what you want. But God is a righteous judge, and there is a season you will stand before him, and you will receive the rewards of not abiding in the vine. Listen to this. The Word of God says this: "Abide in the true vine, because you can't bear fruit in yourself." Oh, Pastor Kenny, I got all kinds of friends. I got friends. Friends love me. We go here. We go to the mall. We do this. We do that. Pastor Kenny, it's so good. I love it. Wait till you get in trouble. You won't be able to find them. "Oh, yes, I will, Pastor Kenny. We are tried and true." Why ain't they here with you? Is the vine not bearing the fruit? Or is that branch being hard-headed and saying no? Or is the fact that they were never asked? You see, I believe with all of my heart, church, we are in the very moments of the last days. Every second of every day, I'm looking for the coming of the Lord Jesus Christ. I'm waiting patiently for his return. Understand this. You can try to do it on your own, but there will come a season when you'll be looking spiritual pigs in the face. I was listening to a radio program the other day on channel 105.1 WAVA. And a woman called in to speak about her situation. Her situation that she had three kids. And she used to go to church. She used to be on fire for God. But things kept getting rougher and rougher. Her husband was addicted to porn. And she begins to cry and weep. And she asked these gentlemen and the lady, "What should I do? I don't even know what to do next." You see, when we leave Jesus out of things, we suffer the consequences of not drawing life from the vine. I want to tell you something. 16 years, Sheila and I have been married. They've not been easy years. When we got married, she had lost her job. She lost her job once since we've been married. We had to quick sell our home. I had to turn in my Harley. We lived on some hot dogs and beans for some time. But how many of you know when you abide in the vine, God makes a way?
That's right. Amen.
And I'm excited today to tell you that abiding in the vine, our marriage is abiding in the vine. We have issues. We don't know where to go. We go to Jesus and pray about it.
Amen.
We have needs. We don't know where to go to get the need met. We go to Jesus and pray about it.
That's right.
They told me at the hospital, said, if we find this to be what the doctor said, you see, when I was at the doctor's office having an appointment, my left foot turned purple. I have a blockage in the top artery of my left foot. My buddy right there said, "Daddy, who's going to preach Sunday?" They told me, if we find this, you're going to have to go into emergency surgery right now. Well, I'm happy to report God answers prayer.
Amen.
And son, here I am. Because I'm abiding in the vine. Amen. And that's what it's all about.
Amen.
And I told him, I said, "Douglas, if God wants a word out, he'll give me strength to do it. I preached with pneumonia. I preached with a broken leg. I'm not bragging on me. I'm bragging on Jesus. I'm telling you what's possible in the vine. I preached worn out. I preached weak revivals and had to almost crawl to get to the last night. I've shared with you before about preaching at the church with over 200 people in it. I was scared. It was all I could do to get up out of the seat when he said, and now Kenneth Woods will be coming to bring the Word of God. And I said, God, I can't do it without you." You say, what is the benefits? What is the fruit of abiding in the vine? How about a young man that night that was going to commit suicide walking up to you and saying, "You preached what I need. Tonight I was going to kill myself. But you've given me hope and you've given me renewed life. And I believe God's going to help me. And I've chosen to live instead of die."
Amen.
That's abiding in the vine. That's abiding in the vine. Listen to this. Are you ready? We have to get our roles straight. Some of us are living like God owes us. Hear what I'm telling you. We become so used to getting what we have that we forget the hand that it came from. We're so used to living where we are now, we tend to forget where we came from. And all of a sudden, where we used to think, thank God for taking us out of the bar, out of the gutter, out of the crack house, out of all these things, out of prostitution, out of all these things. Now we live life. I'm a Christian. Good for me. And we forget that it was a nail-scarred hand belonging to the vine that reached down and lifted us out. You see, can I just remind you one more time? Jesus is your vine. You are not the vine. Oh, I've worked hard to get everything I've got. Can I tell you, in one day, Job lost everything he had. In one day, he lost his fields, his crops, he lost his animals, he lost his children, listen, are you hearing what I'm telling you? He was touched in his body and became ill. He lost everything. Everything, church. Everything that he held precious. But I want to tell you, that righteous man Job was abiding in the vine. Because these are the words of the man abiding in the vine who lost everything. The Lord giveth and the Lord taketh away. But blessed be the name of the Lord Most High. Yeshua made a way. The vine made the way. All of his friends turned on him. You must have sinned. What did you do against God? And his sickness, his precious wife, wanting him to have relief, told him, Job, why don't you curse God and die? What does that tell me? That tells me Job's wife wasn't abiding in the vine. Oh, she might have been hung on the vine. But I'm going to tell you this, and I want you to hear it plain. Because I'm bringing a word from the Lord. If your salvation has become boring to you, you better get back on your knee and cry out to the vine. Because he is the light and he is the giver of life. Hallelujah.
Amen.
He is the light of the world. Hello. He is the hope of America. He is the hope of my home. He is the hope of my family. He is the hope of everything that I have. Church, it is important to abide in the vine. Listen to this. You and I are just simple branches. If we're connected to the vine that brings forth grapes, we're going to be given the pollination to bring forth grapes. And in due season, Sister Ashley, my buds are going to become something wonderful that will squirt in my mouth, Brother Tom, when I chew into it, and will refresh my palate when I taste it and it goes down. Can I tell you something? Taste and see that the Lord is good. His mercy endureth forever, and he comes to all and every generation. Church, I want to share something with you. When we get our roles reversed, we can do nothing fruitful. How many of you have ever seen a cart in front of a horse? Anybody ever been in Amish country? Praise the Lord. Sheila and I went to Dayton, and there they have an Amish market. Hallelujah. Sister Debbie, they have parking places for everybody. They have handicapped spaces. And just down over the hill, they have horse and buggy spaces, Brother Steve. Now, when we went there one time, I thought it was cute that they had horse and buggy standard there. Right? I mean, come on. We're in 2014 at the time. Who in the world is going to be riding horse? They had yellow signs, horse and buggy. Caution, beware. And the buggies have little triangular signs. And they're riding their horse, and I saw him hitch up to the post. But let me tell you a little secret. The horse was in front of the buggy doing the manual labor. The battle is the Lord's. The victory is yours. Let him have it.
Amen.
Let him have it. And you just abide in the vine. And if you're thirsty, let him drink. If you're hungry, let him eat. For I am the river of life, and I am the bread of life, saith the Lord. Hallelujah. If you want something from God, go to Him and ask Him. If you need something from the Lord, go to Him and ask Him. If you need peace of mind, go back to the vine. But if you don't get your role straight, your request is amiss. You see, Jesus will not share His glory with no one. God will not share His glory with no one. In the vine you produce, out of the vine you die, and you're cast into a fire. That sounds simple enough, doesn't it? In the vine you live, you become green, you become fruitful, you produce. We were riding in the country yesterday. We saw all those beautiful colored leaves. Aren't they beautiful? Sister Elfrida took a picture of a tree. It was a bright red tree. And she said, Pastor Kenny, how do you like this? I said, Sister, that is beautiful. Where is that? Outside the churchyard. See, them leaves are turning colors. In case you didn't notice, when you walked here into the door, the leaves are falling, Brother Steve. It's the season of rest. How many in the church needs a season of rest? Mm-hmm. Man, you're weary. The struggle's been hard. It's been long. It's been just a journey and a half. And your spirit needs rest. But you see, Brother Steve, all them twigs and all them branches out there in the yard, they belong to a tree that no longer they desire or desire to draw sustenance from, and they died. Now wait a minute, I got one more. The Bible says this. He says the vine also produces branches that produce fruit. Hallelujah. Sound good, doesn't it? But the husbandman comes along and prunes the branch back. Why am I going through a hard time? Because Jesus wants to show up strong in your life.
That's right. Amen.
You don't go through a test that Jesus isn't planning on making a testimony.
Amen.
The pages of your life are not finished. Jesus has the authority to call. That's all, folks. The end of the book. But you understand, those who are abiding in the vine, though we may be pruned back, and though fall may be here, and the leaves are falling, brother, off of the tree, in just a few short months will come spring.
Yes.
And death shall rise again. Hallelujah. And it shall produce the leaves one more time. And it shall produce the fruit of the tree one more time. And though we may seem to be dead, yet shall we live, because we are abiding in the vine. Don't count us out. We're still abiding in the vine.
Amen.
Hallelujah. We're still abiding in the vine. Now here's the good parts about abiding in the vine. When you abide in the vine, you produce. Happy, happy, happy. Hallelujah. When you abide in the vine, you produce. Let me just give you a little secret. It may be another branch right close to you that you're going through the trouble you're going through that's watching your life. And you may not see the fruit on your branch, but you look across where the branch was dead, and all of a sudden now it's got plums on it. Because it saw you abiding in the vine. and got into the vine and it began to produce fruit, and God the husbandman was happy with you and rejoiced in you. Listen to this, church. Why do I want to abide in the vine? Listen to the answer. Because you can ask for what you want and He'll give it to you. I just want to share with you, God not only meets your needs, sometimes He gives you what you want.
Amen.
Hallelujah. But all the time, He's looking out for your welfare. Hello? Sometimes the no answer is the right answer. Sometimes the wait a minute, wait for a week, wait for a month, wait for a year is the right answer. Let me just ask you today, if somebody walked up with $1 million and placed it in your pocket and said, this is for you, what would you do with it? Somebody called me to ask me that. I got a phone call on the church phone and they asked, is this the pastor? And I said, this is the pastor. They said, we have a question. We're doing a survey. We'd like to ask. We're asking pastors of all denominations and all faith. If we knew an individual who was looking to give $1 million to a church or a private industry, what would you do with it? Brother Tom, I have to be honest. He caught me off guard because I've never had $1 million. And I said, well, let me think a minute. I said, well, without hesitation, the first thing I do is write a check for 10% to the Lord or more. Because you see, anything He gives me, He gives it out of His hand. I said, and then we were running a homeless ministry. And I'd write out a check to make sure that was taken care of. They said, don't you want to spend any on yourself? I said, I ain't got there yet. They said, well, what else would you do with it? I said, I'd go out and buy me a building, and I'd bring homeless people in off the street, and I'd bring veterans in off the street, and I'd house them into that unit as many as I could, and I'd give them food, and I'd give them training to get them a job, and I'd give them the ability to put money into a bank account so that they could put it together and get money enough to rent an apartment, to get them up on their feet, to get them off the street. I'd ensure that was done. I'd take and give money to a ministry we had called Falcons Children's Home Ministry. It's for orphanages, so that I know the little children would be taken care of. I write out that check. They said, you're running out of money. I said, let me just share something with you. If God sees fit to have some organization give me $1 million and I run out of $1 million, He'll find another to give me another $1 million. But I'm going to give God His due, and then whatever's left I'm going to rejoice in. You see, I've got to understand, I abide in the vine. Ask what you will.
Right.
It just don't work. I asked God to send me someone to help with our youth. It worked. I asked God to send us more musicians. It worked. I'm still praying for more, Brother Tom. I'm looking for a keyboard player. I'm looking for a bass player. I'm looking to give God the best that we've got. You understand, church? Abiding in the vine, God can do anything. There are branches out there. We just have to wait till we're yoked together. Let me talk just for a few minutes of the husbandman. The husbandman's job is to ensure that every branch in the vine is healthy. He keeps an eye on the tree, on the vine. So not only am I abiding in Jesus, I have Almighty God watching me. Whom shall I fear? If God be for us, who can be against us? You may come at me with a spear and a sword, with all the training the world has to give. There's some concern that on Tuesday at polling places there will be trouble with ISIS. I'm going to be there to vote. Because absent from the body is to be joined closer to the vine. You understand that, don't you? If not, let me just share it with you. This world is not my home. I'm just passing through. My treasure has been laid up somewhere beyond the blue. There's a whole lot of people expecting me. That's one thing I know. How many of you with me, church?
Amen.
The husbandman watches over me. I'm not going to die until the husbandman says he's ready for me to come home. And I'm going to tell you there's still a work I feel that needs to be done. And I'm on the battlefield. I'm on the battlefield. I said I'm on the battlefield. Church, come on. We are on the battlefield for the Lord.
Yes.
So let come what may. Let the storm clouds rise. I'm sheltered safe in the arms of the husbandman.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. He prunes back the tree. Don't be satisfied with what you've got. Keep striving for more of God. Be satisfied with your worldly materials and rejoice for when you get more. But don't get satisfied with God. Because when you stop learning, when you stop growing, when you stop looking into the Word of God and finding golden nuggets buried deep into the treasures of this book, you're going to die. And you're going to not only die physically, but you're going to die spiritually. I wouldn't care if you died physically and there was no afterlife to go to. But I want to tell you something. The Bible says it is appointed unto man once to die. But then he'll face the judgment. We're all going to die. I hate to say that. Sheila hates when I say that. Sheila hates thinking about me dying and leaving her by herself. And Douglas don't like that thought, but I'm here to share with you. God has promised me something better than what I got now.
Amen.
I'm going home. I'm going home. I'm going home to be with Grandma. I'm going home to be with Mama. I'm going home to be with Daddy. I'm going home to be with Patty. I'm going home to be with Jesus. I'm going home to sit in the lap of God. His lap is big enough to hold me. He cuts off dead branches so they don't hinder the ones that are growing. Listen to what I'm telling you, church. I'm preaching to you from the word that God has laid in my heart. We need to sever some of our relationships so that we can grow in God. So many people come to me and said, will you marry us? He ain't saved. I am. Will you marry? No. Why not, Pastor? Because the Bible says you should not be unequally yoked together. And he'll end up killing you. Oh, no, sir. No, sir. He promised to go to church with me. I want to tell you something. The devil go to church every day. But he ain't going to heaven. If you really love him, give him a chance to find God. Because he won't be the husband you want until he does. If he can't love God who loves him unconditionally, how's he going to love you with all of his faults? And with all of yours. I'm preaching for somebody today. Hear the word of the Lord. Hear the word of the Lord. God is shaking the tree. There's a whole lot of people that call themselves Christians that aren't. How do you know that, Pastor Kenny? What's amazing, when you ask someone, are you a Christian, they say yes. When you ask them, have you asked Jesus into your heart, they don't understand what you're talking about. Can I share with you, you can't be a Christian until first you're in Christ. Ooh, that's hard preaching, Pastor Kenny. I know, but I'm doing it through the help and grace of God. Why? Because God cares about our soul. And finally in closing today, God is glorified when you bring forth fruit. God is glorified when we bring forth fruit. I was in a restaurant, if you want to call Roy Rogers a restaurant. I was in that fancy one, Sir Roy Rogers. And there was a little woman there. And I smiled. And I said, "Hey, how are you doing?" And she looked at me so perplexed. She said this: "Did you know you're the only one in the place smiling?" I didn't even notice. How many of you know when you're abiding in the vine, sometimes the world just has to back off? And I looked around and I said, "You're right." She said, "You must know Jesus." I didn't have a bumper sticker on my car. I didn't have a t-shirt that said, "Jesus Lover." On the back said, "I'm a Christian." I'm just going to be real. Some of you need to scrape the bumper stickers off your car the way y'all act. That's why I don't have one on mine. I mean, y'all know I get frustrated. Somebody cuts me off too. Hello. Ooh, you're preaching now, Pastor. I've been preaching. It's good you woke up. Amen. Hello. Can I share something with you, church? You just love God and love your neighbor like you love yourself. They'll know what you are. And they're going to want what you got. I went in Friday. And I got to visit with Sister Simpson. When I walked in, looking for her, I have to be honest, I couldn't pick her out of the whole crowd. And a nurse walked over to me and said, "Who are you looking for, sir?" I said, "I'm looking for Miss Virginia Simpson." "She's right there." I wasn't maybe 3 feet away from her. I said, "Oh." She walked over, she said, "Miss Simpson, you got someone here to see you." And I walked towards Sister Simpson, and she said, "I'll get you a chair." And I touched Sister Simpson's arm. And I said, "Hey, sister, I love you. How are you?" And a big smile came on her face. She said, "Pastor Kenny." Amen. And she told me a whole lot of things. I don't even know what they were about. But she smiled saying them. And I smiled nodding, "Uh-huh, I get you." And she was getting lunch. And I was going to get lunch. How many of y'all like it when we come in agreement about food? Amen?
Amen.
And I said, "Sister Simpson, before I leave, would it be all right to pray for you?" And the guy sitting across from us said, "You sure have got a good friend there." Yeah. And I began to pray for Sister Simpson. And I prayed over her food, because y'all know cafeteria food ain't the best. She might have been getting a hamburger. I was praying it tastes like filet mignon. Amen. And I prayed for all the people sitting at the table. And when I got ready to leave, the man across the table said, "Thanks for the prayer." Church, we're bearing fruit by abiding in the vine. I'm sorry sometimes we as a church, we as the body of Christ, have to endure things. But I'm happy to tell you today that whatever's causing you trouble now is another stepping stone towards your entrance into heaven.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
One more wrong on the ladder.
Hallelujah.
One more trial, one more tribulation, one more valley I got to go through, leaving this world behind. Hello? I've come too far to look back, man. I don't want to be a wasteful pillar of salt. I want to be a vine in, or branch in the vine with Jesus Christ. I want to be someone that don't have to put the bumper sticker on their car. They can just love and smile at you. And you know. We were at the pastor's meeting, Sheila and I. And Bishop came over. Bishop Gary Bright, you remember him? Mm-hmm. His daddy was a pastor in his church. How many of y'all love them Christian hugs?
Yeah.
Can I just tell you something? I was worshiping the Lord and Sheila nudged me. I was like, what do you want? Oh. And he said, how are you, Pastor? I said, I'm good. How are you? You know that, Steve, that spiritual greet. I've reached my hand out to shake his. He said, I don't want a handshake. He reached in and he wanted me to hug him. And I reached that one-arm brotherly love hug, man. Can I tell you? And he looked at me and he said, no, like you mean it. One of them Christian hugs. Draw me in and caress me in the love of God.
Right.
Oh, what was that? Something sexual? Uh-uh. That was two branches abiding in the vine.
Right.
Drop some of your friends that are doing things contrary to the Word of God. And be the bold one at the flag praying for the school.
Right.
I'm reminded of a kid. How many of y'all saw this on Facebook? He would not go into the school because the school would not let him pray until he stood at the front door and said his prayer for the morning. And then he went into school. They're trying to expel that child because they're refusing to go into the school. How many of you know we need some more praying for our school?
Amen.
By our parents and by our children. Amen?
Amen?
Hallelujah. Don't let your friends win you. You win them.
Amen.
Hallelujah. It's going to be a conscientious choice to abide in the vine. Well, I'm feeling pretty dry, Pastor Kenny. Go get a drink.
Hallelujah.
Can I do that now? You sure can. There's no time like the present to get back into the vine. Would you bow your heads today? Hallelujah. Precious Heavenly Father, Almighty God, hallelujah. We recognize you today as the husbandman. And of assurance, we know today that you are pruning the vine. And you are casting out the branches that are dead and are draining the life of the tree by not accepting the life from the tree. For every branch that beareth no fruit is cast into the fire. That's what your word says. But today, God, we pray, make us fruitful. And we pray it in the name of the vine, Jesus Christ. God, that joy would realm in our hearts and peace would be the focus of our mind. Lord, you know every person in this place and you know those that are watching by internet or will be watching by internet. God, you know their heart, you know their soul, you know right where they are in this moment, in this very hour. I'm asking in the mighty name of Jesus that you would sweep over this congregation. And Lord, the congregation by internet and those that will view in the archive. And Father, that your Spirit will reach out to their heart and woo them back to the vine. Today, God, I run to the rock of my salvation. I go to the stone that the builders rejected. I run to the mountain, and the mountain stands by me. Lord, the earth all around me may be sinking sand, but on the vine, on the rock, Christ Jesus, I'll stand. I go to the rock. I run to the rock of my salvation. The stone the builder rejected. And Lord, I ask you today, as we're seeking you with all of our heart, that you would do a work within us. God, in souls today, there are people, Lord, I believe you're moving in their hearts. And Lord, they know people they ought not be hanging around. And I pray in a righteous and a holy way, God, that you would sever the sinful tie. And Lord, with the umbilical cord of your Spirit, you would draw them to salvation. So Lord, that we would reach them and they would not reach us. That we would give them the good news, and Lord, they would become part of the vine. Lord, while it's so true that you ate with sinners, it is no less true that you did not partake in that sin. So Lord, we ask to make us more like you. And Father, we ask God for every soul, that it would bear fruit. And Lord, that the fruit of the Spirit would abound in our lives. In the precious name of Jesus, I pray. And I thank you, Lord. Amen. And amen. Amen. Would you do me a favor and stand to your feet today? Would you find 3-4 people to make your prayer unit with today? Come on. Reach out across the way. Stretch around to the back, the front, wherever you have to go. Now, church, would you just begin to pray for them and to love them in Jesus' name? See who's in your unit and begin calling out to God on their behalf. As the vines are praying, as we're holding up one another's burdens, as we're reaching the throne of glory. Heavenly Father, work through the units of these hands. Let our hands be your hands, God, to this world. Let our prayer be that this sparks your hearing. God, I pray for every need, Lord, that's being prayed for today, every person, God. Lord, that you would supply their needs according to your riches and glory. For you said, if I abide in you, I can ask what I will. And you would do it. Lord, I can't be without you. God, I've got to have you. And Lord, I ask today that you would touch through these hands. And God, I pray, Lord, that you would minister unto these needs. For Lord, you are the one that can do it when I can't. You are the one who can touch when I can't. But Lord, you are the one who can supply our needs according to your riches and glory. So I look to you today. You have never failed us yet. I pray you would open up doors that cannot be closed and close doors that cannot be opened. For this we pray, as you prayed in the garden. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Jehovah God, give us this day our daily bread. And forgive us of our trespasses, as we forgive those who sinned and trespassed against us. Lord, keep us from temptation, and deliver us from evil. For you are the power and the kingdom and the glory forever and forever. And we recognize that in Jesus' name. Amen and amen.